एम्पियर सर्किट लॉ. व्हाट इज दिस लॉ? दिस लॉ इज सिमिलर टू बायट सेवर्ट लॉ, बट ऑफ कोर्स स्टेटमेंट इज डिफरेंट. बोथ आर बीइंग यूज्ड टू फाइंड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड ड्यू टू डिफरेंट सिस्टम्स. Let's see what is the statement of Ampere's circuit law. If you want, you can note it down. It states that the line integral of a magnetic field over a closed loop coinciding with the boundaries of the surface coinciding with the boundaries of the surface is mu naught times the total current threading through the loop or total current passing through the loop. What exactly it means? See, if there is a loop, a straight conductor or some current is passing through the loop, I, radius of loop is say R, an element radius is R, an element length is dl, then from Ampere circuit law B dot dl is equal to mu naught times I. Remember, it talks about the current which is threading through the loop. Mu naught is magnetic permeability, as we know. If we fill this region of the loop with any other material, then this will have mu naught mu r, relative permeability. So that's what is the statement. For any other medium, this integral will have a look like mu naught mu r I. Right? Now see applications of Ampere's. Applications of Ampere's circuit law. First application, I take magnetic field at a point due to infinitely long straight conductor. So let us assume there is an infinitely long straight conductor carrying current I, and I want to find the magnetic field at point P. So first thing, you enclose this point in a closed loop, element, choose an element of length dl, radius you can take it as R. Go to the LHS of equation B dot dl, you first solve this scalar product. Due to straight conductor, direction of magnetic field at point P will be like this inside. Element and these two are at in the same direction, because you see conductor is like this. Conductor is this, point P is here. Element direction will be given by the tangent drawn. So at this point, direction of magnetic field, see here. Same. So angle is 0. So you can put it as BDN. And then since theta is 0, so cos 0 is 1. Now you are left with a simple integration. BDN, B you can bring out of the integration, DL. DL is total length of the loop, that is equal to 2 pi r circumference. Go to equated RHS, B 2 pi r is equal to mu naught I. So B is equal to mu naught I over 2 pi r. This you have already seen. Even in case of same result by using Biot-Savart law. If you plot a graph between magnetic field and position of a point, then obviously it is bearing reciprocal to the distance. So the graph will be r equals to 0, then b will be infinity. When r is infinity, b is 0. So it won't touch anywhere on y-axis and x-axis. So you can start from somewhere parallel to this and then finally drop in parallel to this. Right? That's how you can calculate and do first application. Second application is magnetic field due to a long circular cylinder or cylinder or conducting cylinder, you can say, that you can also consider as a thick wire carrying current. So I consider a thick wire, cylindrical wire of radius capital R carrying current I, direction is shown. So the first case we will develop here as number one, when point P lies outside. That is R is greater than R. Point P lies somewhere here. So again you have to make a loop and this radius is R. Fine. So go to the RHS again. In integration V dot DL, this you will put it as DL. Condition is same again. Theta is 0. So that comes out B into 2 pi small r. Now this entire conductor is passing through the loop and carrying current I. So RHS will be equal to mu naught I, equating LHS and RHS, mu naught I. So B is equal to mu naught I over 2 pi r. Result is similar to a straight thin conductor. That is, magnetic field is inversely proportional to R. Now case 2. When point P lies inside the conductor. So you have to have a thick cylinder assumption now carrying current I and the radius is R. Point P lies inside. So you have to choose a circular loop, a small r like this. Now, since this is applicable only for a wire threading through the loop, so only this portion of the cylinder is passing through the loop, not entire cylinder, because rest of the cylinder portion is out of the loop. So you will not take into account. So go to the LHS again. That is integration V dot dl mu naught I1. I don't know how much current we have to calculate. Right? So first we will calculate LHS. That will be better. Let's calculate LHS first, and that is easier one. That is V into dl. That is B into 2 pi R, equation number 1. Now RHS will be equal to mu naught into total current which is passing through the loop I, but this is not I dash I can take because it's not equal to I. So for RHS, first we have to calculate current density, current flowing through unit area, that is you can say rho is equal to I over area of this is pi r square, capital R square. Therefore, I dash is equal to rho into area of loop, that is rho into, sorry, so rho value we have already, we can put it, we can put the value of rho here. I over pi r square into pi small r square. So this is the current. Now you can equate LHS and RHS. So V into 2 pi r is equal to mu naught. I dash is I R square over R square, 1 R cancels, so V is equal to mu naught I over mu naught I R over 2 pi R square. Look at this relation. In this relation, V is directly proportional to R. So inside the conductor, V is directly proportional to R. Outside the conductor, V is inversely proportional to R. And at the surface, it will have maximum value. Right? However, we have to introduce here mu R also. Because inside the conductor, material is not air. So in fact, we have to put mu naught mu r I into r over 2 pi r square because conductor is solid. Now if again someone asks you to plot a graph between magnetic field and position of the point, so you can easily plot, there is no problem. There are two situations. Number one, it increases linearly till what? R equals to R. When R becomes greater than R, then it varies 1 by R. So you will have a graph of 1 by R. And if you put R equals to R in this expression, so you will have mu naught I 2 pi r. So this will be the maximum value. Mu naught I mu r I by 2 pi r. Third application, magnetic field due to solenoid. Before that, going through this article and derivation, let us know what is solenoid. Solenoid is nothing as a particular shape, helical shape. If you have a long straight insulating conducting wire wrap over this wire, over this marker, and then remove a spring. Have you seen a spring? That is a helical shape. So turning a long straight conducting wire, insulated conducting wire, into a helix shape, it becomes a solenoid. When current is passed through a solenoid, the magnetic field is confined within the solenoid only. At any point lying outside the solenoid, the magnetic field is negligible, almost zero, or you can consider even zero when you compare the magnitude of magnetic field inside along the axial line of solenoid. So we consider here N be the number of turns per unit length, I is the current which we have assumed. To find out magnetic and using magnetic field due to this solenoid, using Ampere's circuital law, so we have made this loop PQRS. Now this closed integration can be break up into two linear integration, that is integration V dot dl P to Q plus integration Q to R V dot dl plus integration R to S V dot dl plus integration S to P V dot dl. Four integration. Now we look at this value V dot dl Q to R and then P to S. These both will be zero. I mean to say integration Q to R V dot dl is equal to integration S to P V dot dl, both are equal to zero. It is because these two elements are perpendicular to the direction of magnetic field. Direction of magnetic field is this, right? Direction of magnetic field is inside the conductor, and these two are at right angle. This is also zero. Here you can say theta is 90. This integration will also be zero. P to Q V dot dl is also zero because magnetic field at any point outside is negligible or zero. Right? Now what is left? 1, 2, 3 are zero. So in the LHS you have R to S V dl, that you can put it as V dl, that is equal to V into L, and then put it equal to right hand side V dot dl mu naught, number of turns per unit length is L, total number of turns into L into I, L cancels, that is B is equal to mu naught I. But at the end, at the ends, magnetic field of the solenoid, ends means here and there, will be equal to mu naught Ni over 2 half. So if we plot a graph between magnetic field and position, there is no symmetry in the line, sorry for that. Graph comes like this. This is a center. This you can say L by 2 plus L by 2 R, other side R. Right? Another application is magnetic field due to toroid. Toroid. What is toroid? It is a solenoid, long solenoid, bent round in form of the circular ring. It is a long solenoid bent round in the form of closed circular ring. This solenoid you can take and twist it, bring in circular form like this. So you can leave one end here. This is the radius R. Let total number of turns R capital N, right? I is the current flowing through this. So go to LHS, integration V dot dl, that finally V closed loop dl, that is V into 2 pi R. Total current is I, so it is mu naught I. N number of turns are also to be counted, so you can put mu naught N I. Equate both, B into 2 pi R is equal to mu naught I. Let's go this side now. So B is equal to mu naught N I over 2 pi R. Look at this expression. 2 pi R is the total length of the conductor. N is the total number of in the toroid. So N over 2 pi R is number of turns per unit length, where N is number of turns per unit length. So there are four applications we have done.